Mr. McGee and his computer class representatives. Mr. McGee and the CNG computer classes. Let's give them a big hand.
Instructor over for Center for a New Generation. And some of the things that we've done this year were to develop web pages. And so this is a very good group right here. And I've been doing this for the past 2 years with Center for a New Generation. And I believe that it's good to expose children of this age to these type of computer skills, so when they get into the high school and the collegiate level, they'll be familiar with the language already. So what I'll do is I'll turn it over to James Smith, and he's just gonna kind of give briefly some of the things that we did this year, as well as how it may help them in the future.
This year, we made web pages. We learned how to post them on the internet. And we learned how to put pictures on there and stuff. And that can help you in the future get a job, because, you know, like, you can make web pages for companies and stuff like that. And you can make web pages for companies. I learned how to use email a little bit better, too. That's it.
Call the third grade class to come up with Ms. Samani and Ms. Parker and Ms. Smith, if you could enter from that side of the stage.
Friendship.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Samani. It was a pleasure to work with your third graders. I truly enjoyed it. I saw a tremendous amount of growth this past year. I saw a tremendous amount of growth this past year. We worked a lot on computation, which is just basic addition, subtraction. They graduated to multiplication as well as division. And I would like to commend them for that. They did a great job. They also learned introduction to algebra. With no further ado, I'd like to introduce Cassandra, which would like to say a few words about what she learned.
Good evening, my name is Cassandra, and we learned a little bit of algebra, and what I liked about Ms. Dr. Samani's class, she taught us division. We also had a party for the last day of seeing Ms. Samani's class. My favorite part of Ms. Samani's class was learning multiplication, division, and addition. That's it.
Okay, third graders, you can come down the stage off the exit this way. I'd like to introduce the fourth grade class, which I'm also very proud of. These guys are really super. We studied a lot of geometry. They did an entire year of focus on geometry. We also did testilization, which is geometric shapes, and it was incredible how they picked it up and really took off with it. We looked at nature and exactly what nature has to offer from a geometric perspective and put it back into math form. So these guys did a terrific job, and I'm very, very proud of them. I'd like to introduce Michelle, who would like to say a few words about what she learned in math class.
For the past year, we've been learning about statistics and geometry, and I've had fun. In the back, there's some papers about how we learn to make pyramids and shapes, and also width and length shapes. We also learned about math and multiplication, and my favorite part of Ms. Samani's class was when we all worked together to make the shapes for the closing ceremony, and all of our class had great fun, and we all liked math.
Ms. Moore could come to the stage. Ms. Moore and her fourth grade science class will have a representative to tell you about that.
Good evening. My name is Brenda Moore, and I had the privilege of working with these wonderful fourth graders in the area of science. And I want to let you know, you parents, you have great potential here in your students, and I would really encourage you all to encourage them in the areas of math and science in particular. We started out the year talking about electricity, but I really admired these group of young people because they quickly let me know, particularly the girls, that they thought we should address more girly science issues. So we had Mariah, who generated a list of 31 different science subjects. And then we very democratically chose three that the class would pursue for the last month or so. So we're going to have Isaias come to you and give you a very brief preview of some of the things that you can find out more about on our display board.
This year, we learn about the flow of electrons that is called current. The girls wanted girly science, so we put three topics. One was rock candy, the other one was cotton candy, the other one was hair. Involving cotton candy, it was crystals. Crystals are the purest substance. This year, I enjoyed science. That's all.
Good evening. My name is Michael Thompson. I had the extreme pleasure of working with the fourth graders in the area of language arts, particularly writing. I have to say, these guys are very creative, very talented when it comes to writing. I think they're all to the point where a five-paragraph essay is no challenge to them anymore. I'm going to call up Sabrina Prasad. She's going to tell us about what exactly they were writing about in fourth grade.
Hello, my name is Sabrina Prasad. Today I'll be telling you what we learned in Mr. Thompson's fourth grade language arts class. We learned how to write paragraphs and turn them into essays. We also learned parts of speech, such as adjectives, nouns, verbs, and adverbs. We learned a lot, and we had a lot of fun. Thank you.
Grading into middle school, so this was a really special year for them. We did some wonderful quantitative work. They did a lot of statistics, probability, math reasoning, logic, and I really followed their lead because they're at a special age where they know where they would like to go with their mathematics. So we also followed the standards of the National Math and Science Institute, as well as the California math standards. I would like Demetrius, he's gonna pitch hit because our speaker became ill today. So he would like to speak for the fifth grade class.
My name is Demetrius. As you all know, what we learned in Dr. Simani's fifth grade math class was that we did things, but some people didn't like them. They didn't understand. So some of the time, Dr. Simani had to work off with them and let the higher people that understood it do what they did, and they went on. Like, we had papers to do, and then she had backup papers when we were done with them. We could just go on and on so we would never run out of work. And then once we went to the park and we made milkshakes, we grabbed a banana shake. We grabbed how much the banana weighed and a pill, the banana pill, how much it weighed, like 7 bananas, and we made a banana shake, and it was pretty tasty. That's it.
To capsulize that unit of study, we went on a metal hunt. We got a metal detector, and we were all convinced that we would come back rich because we discovered gold in the parking lot at Flood School. Well, as you can imagine, that didn't work out, but we had a lot of fun anyway. We also talked about the respiratory system and the circulatory systems, and we're going to have Demetrius come again. He has graciously consented to be the spokesman for the fifth grade science class as well.
With the periodic table of elements. The
introduce the fifth grade language arts class. These are published authors. Like you all give them a big hand. Their book is on display. It's called On Tour in Our Neighborhoods. It's on display for any of you who'd like a copy. This semester, they worked very hard to publish these essays, and I'm going to have Amelia Hopoy come and speak to you about their experience.
Program. instructions and the four types of errors found in computer programming. Lexical, syntactic, execution, and intent. In entomology, the study of insects, we talked about why insects are so successful in their survival. Small size, portability, and exoskeleton helps insects to survive. Insects have successfully inhabited every part of the globe except the oceans, where we find our last study, marine biology. We looked at whales and dolphins whose superior intelligence distinguished them among sea creatures. And now, let's meet Harold.
To call up Mr. Thompson, our sixth grade language arts teacher, Mr. Thompson.
Sixth grade class has had a great pleasure, I think, about writing about themselves. They've learned a great deal about their past, the present, and future, and they've expressed that in some very excellent stories that are on display back there, and I know they've seen and taken over the form as well. So I'd like actually to have Christina Neal is about to tell us about sixth grade language arts class. Stories and typed them on the computer, and they're in the back.
baskets we were going to make for Easter with the tissue paper, but it didn't really work out. And mostly, the thing I liked about our class is that you use your imagination a lot, and you get to do a lot of things that you regularly don't write on paper. You just pull it out from your imagination. Now Mariah will speak.
I didn't want to leave the elementary school without acknowledging a key parent that has participated since the beginning of the year. She's been my right arm. She's made copies. She's helped with management. And I'd like to ask Brandon, very quickly, to come up. And thanking me, his mom, Jamie Bow. Can you please give her a hand?
My son has been at Flint School for 4 years now. And this is not something that I want to be thankful for. This is something that I felt that was my privilege and something that was my duty as a parent to do. I'm really proud to have been able to come in and help these children and be with them every single day. And you guys are winners, every one of you. And I'm really proud. So thank you.
Now, into middle school. Working with the 7th and 8th graders was a challenge. I was called to the table, and it was a wonderful challenge for me. I learned a great deal in working with them, and we did some tremendous work, beginning with integers, which is the beginning of pre-algebra, going into polynomials, as well as different types of algebraic equations. And our final project, which is in the back there, is an integrated teen center. So they began to think about where they would like to spend some of their extra time and bringing in the concept of the Boys and Girls Club. So I think it was a wonderful experience for them. They built round with applause.
Find out what class.
We learned a lot of things like making digital movies and new friendships. And some of the movies were based on family and friends and how drugs affect like school, your performance, my tests and stuff. And some people who I work with were Mr. Gonzalez and Mr. Thompson. And they made them do it very helpful. So I thank you for that. And it's all to place to keep food. And that's why I do this. Thank you.
He has four major goals. They're to help students get excited about learning. They're to help them succeed in school during their elementary and middle school years. They're to help get parents involved. Children's education, and ultimately we want all of our students to get on the college track in high school and have choices when they graduate. Center for
Thank you. It's been a lot of fun. I love to work with talented students, and these are some of the most talented students at CNG. Así que muchas gracias por compartir sus hijos con nosotros. Los queremos muchísimo. Gracias.
Thank you.
So next you'll be serenaded first by the clarinets and saxophones playing their warm-up scale, then some Frère Jacques, and Yankee Doodle, and then some C&G participatory song, and then we're going to hear from the jazz part of our instrumental music program.
That we've been learning. Thank you. Give yourself a big hand.
and I learned about Danny G's classes that to dance and dance good, and I think Danny G is the
thank you. Kiba.
I'm not afraid to
Okay, everyone, you guys all know what the point system is, right? Which student wants to come up here and talk about the point system? Monet. Our very own Monet Clemens. Give her a round of applause.
But the first She emailed me her points. Mr. and Mrs. Monahan. Mr. and Mrs. McDaniel. Miss Rice, can you please come up here?
Yeah.